Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel again. In this video we are going to solve some question, as you can see from the copy, some question of CBSE class 10 standard, some easy questions. Now here one question is given, as you can see, so I am just doing the answer of it. Now here the question I am reading, that if the sum of the first n term of an arithmetic progression is given by Sn is equal to 3n square minus n, then find T1, D and Tn of that progression. Okay. So we have to find that. Now here Sn is equal to given 3n square minus n. We have to find Sn minus 1, that's equals to 3 into n minus 1 square minus n minus 1. Okay. Now Tn, suppose we have one series. Okay, we have one series, then the Tn of that series, suppose we have one arithmetic progression, then the Tn of that arithmetic progression should be Sn minus S n minus 1, that is sum of n minus 1 term of that related arithmetic progression, that should be subtracted from the sum of n term of that arithmetic progression, then we get the Tn, the nth term of that arithmetic progression. Hope you will have understood. So here Tn is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1, so that means Sn means 3 n square minus n minus Sn minus 1, that equals to 3 into n minus 1 square minus n minus 1. Okay, so that's equals to the calculating, this is 3 n square minus 2 n plus 1 minus n plus 1, 3 n square minus n minus 3 n square plus 6 n minus 3 plus n minus 1. This term should be cancelized. This we are getting 6 n minus 4. So my Tn should be 6 n minus 4. Okay. So this is the answer, this is one answer. Next we have to find T1, putting the value of 1, 6 into 1 in place of n minus 4, that is 6 minus 4, that is 2. Next we have to find D of that series. So here T1 is 2, T2 we have to find, T2 means 6 into 2 minus 4, that means 12 minus 4, that is equal to 8. So D should be T2 minus T1, that is term 2 minus term 1, so that is equal to 8 minus 2, that is 6. So that is one answer. Hope you will have understood. Next move to another question. So this is the solution, that is T1 is equal to, this is one answer, T1 is equal to 2, Tn is equal to 6n minus 4 and D is equal to 6. Okay. Next move to another question. Now here in this question, how many natural numbers in between 100 and 500 which is exactly divisible by 8? So here comes the solution. Numbers which are in between 100 and 500 divisible by 8 are what? 104, 112, okay. Next 120, next 128, next 496, okay. Now here, as you can see, this 496, this is the last term, that is the nth term. So we should take it as Tn. Tn is equal to 496, and we know for an AP, for an arithmetic progression, which has the first term as A with n terms and common difference d, Tn should be A plus n minus 1 into d. So here A is equal to 104, d is equal to 8, and Tn is equal to 496. So this 496 is equal to 104 plus n minus 1 into d, d means 8. Now if we calculate it, we are getting the 496 minus 104. This 2 is 392. 392, that's equals to n minus 1 into 8. So n minus 1 should be 392 by 8. If we calculating, we are getting 49 over here. So if we calculate it, 392 over 8, this is 72, 49. So n should be how much? N should be 49 plus 1. So that's equals to 50. So total 50 terms in this arithmetic progression. There are total 50 terms. Okay. So there are total 50 terms. So the total numbers we can write, that which is exactly divisible by 8, numbers which are exactly divisible by 8 in between 100 and 500 are, total number are how much? 50. That is the n of this arithmetic progression. Okay, and this is Tn. Next, move to another question. Next, this question: 36x square minus 12ax plus 36 square minus 12ax plus a square minus b square equal to 0. We have to solve it by Sridhar Acharya formula. Now, for a standard equation, standard quadratic equation, a x square plus b x plus c is equal to 0, where a, b, c real and a obviously not equal to 0. Comparing with, this is 1, this is 2. Comparing 1 with 2, we are getting a is equal to 36, b is equal to minus 12a, c is equal to a square minus b square. So the root should be x is equal to minus b plus minus root over of b square minus 4ac, b square minus 4ac by 2a. Now minus b, that means plus 12a, plus minus root over of b square. B square means minus 12a whole square, b square minus 4ac, 4 into a, 36 into c, a square minus b square. Hope you are able to see it. Divided by twice a. Now this is 12a plus minus, this is root over of 144 a square minus this, if you multiply this this should be 144 a square plus 144 b square divided by twice a. So from that equation we are getting the value of x should be 12 a plus minus 144 a square, 144 a minus 144 a square should be cancelized, plus minus 12 b by 2 a. Okay, 2 a means 2 into 36, so we put the value over here, 2 into 36. Actually we have to put the value in the previous line, you must do that. So here that's equals to, we are taking 12 common from here, a plus minus b by this is 72 is 6. So x should be a plus b by 6 and a minus b by 6, the two value of x. So this is one solution and this is one another solution. So these two are the answer. Next, move to another. Here it is given, find the roots of the equation. Now as you can see from this equation, this is not a linear equation, this is a quadratic equation, so we have to solve it. Now from here, this is a very easy question. So here we have to calculate just. So we are taking the LCM. This we have to calculate, this we are getting is 3x plus 2, this equals to 2x square plus 6x minus x minus 3, that equal to 11 by 7x plus 9. So this is 3x plus 2, 7x plus 9 by 2x square plus 6x plus 5x minus 3, that's equals to 11. Now hope you are able to see it. Now this you have to multiply, that is 21 x square plus 14x plus 27x plus 18, that's equals to 22 x square plus 55x minus 33. We are just moving these expressions to here. We are getting x square 22 minus 21 plus x into 55 minus 14 minus 27 plus 33 is here. So that's equals to 151, that's equals to 0. Now this equals to x square, if we calculate it, we are getting 14x minus 51 equal to 0, that's equals to x square plus 17x minus 3x minus 51 equal to 0. Taking x common, we are getting x plus 17 minus 3 common, x plus 17, that's equals to 0. So x plus 17 into x minus 3, that's equal to 0. So the x equal to 3 either, or x equals to minus 17. So that will be the solution of this required equation. If you have to check it, so let's check for the value of minus 17. So we are getting the LHS is equal to minus 17, that means 1 by minus 17 plus 3 plus 1 by 2 into minus 17 minus 1. This is the LHS. So 1 by minus 14 plus 1 by minus 35. Okay. That means 1 by minus 14 minus 1 by 35. If we take minus 1 by 7 common, we are getting 1 by, if we take RHS, taking the RHS, 11 by 7 into minus 17 plus 9. So here this is equal to 11. So here this is 7, 5 plus 2 7, so that means minus 1 by 10. So LHS would be 1 minus 1 by 10. Now here again we are calculating, this is minus 7 into 17. Minus 119 plus 9, that is 11 divided by minus 110. If we calculating, we are getting minus 1 by 10. So for this value x equal to minus 17, we are getting LHS equal to RHS, verified. Okay, next move to another. So here 1 and 2 are the two zeros of the polynomial. We have to find the third zero. So here comes the answer. Since 1 and 2 are the zero of the polynomial, and the given polynomial is, I am writing x cube minus 4x square minus 7x plus 10 equal to 0. This is the given polynomial. Now since these are the two zeros of this polynomial, so obviously 1 and 2 be the two zeros of this polynomial. So obviously x minus 1 and x plus 2 be the two factors of polynomial 1 of polynomial px, that is 1. Understood? So now if we multiply this x minus 1 with x plus 2, we are getting x square minus x plus 2x minus 2, x square plus x minus 2. Now this is the divisor polynomial and this is the dividend polynomial. We have to make it. This is the divisor polynomial and this is the dividend polynomial. Okay. We have to divide this. This is x cube plus x square minus 2x, changing the sign. So here this cancelize, minus 5x square minus 5x plus 10. Now we are taking minus sign, that is minus 5 minus 5x square minus 5x minus plus 10, changing again the sign, we are getting this as 0. So again we are getting that x minus 1 be a factor of equation number 1. So obviously the third zero will be x minus 5 equal to 0, that is x equal to 5, so x equal to 5 should be the third zero. Let's move to another question. Now here it is given that minus 1 should be a zero of this polynomial. We have to find all other zero. So for that we have to now let us take the answer to the answer. There are two methods. The first method that I have already done, that is by taking divisor polynomial and make this as dividend polynomial, divide that, that should be one process, and that should be one another process. That is, since minus 1 be a 0 of given polynomial px, say obviously x plus 1 be a factor. Okay, now since x plus 1 be a factor, so we have to factorize this cubic polynomial. Okay, now factorization of cubic polynomial we have already done in class 9. Hope you are able to see. We are taking this factor over here. So taking x square over here, x cube plus x square plus x square plus x minus 12 minus 12x minus 12. So x plus 1 x square plus x minus 12. Now again we have to factorize it. X plus 1, this is one factor we have to make to factorize it. So if we factorize it, we are getting x square plus 4x minus 3x minus 12. So x plus 1, this is x plus 4, taking 3 common, x plus 4, x plus 1, x plus 4 and x minus 3. Now this polynomial has been factorized with these three terms. So from here we can say that the other zeros, the other factor we are getting x plus 4 and x minus 3. So other zeros are x plus 4 equal to 0, that's equal to x equal to minus 4, and x minus 3 equal to 0, that's implying x equal to plus 3. So the other zeros are minus 4 and plus 3. So this is one method. It could be solved in another method by dividing the given polynomial with x plus 1, and we are getting the quotient polynomial. We have to factorize the quotient polynomial. We have to get, definitely we get the other zeros. So next, move to another question. So this is one question that we have to solve in graphically. Since I have no proper graph paper, but I definitely try to solve it in this paper also. So by graphically show that x minus 2y is equal to 2 and 4x minus y is equal to 5 is consistent. Now for consistency checking, what we have to do? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2. If A1 by A2 is not equals to B1 by B2, then the system is what? The system should be consistent. So here A1 is equal to the coefficient of first equation 1, B1 equal to coefficient of y in the first equation is equal to minus 2, A2 is equal to 4 and B2 is equal to minus 2. Okay. So A1 by A2 here, that's equals to 1 by 4, and B1 by B2, that's equals to minus 2 by minus 2, that is 1. So obviously here these are consistent. These are consistent. That means they should meet this two straight line. This is the equation of straight line. These two straight line should meet at one point. Now taking the graph paper. Now from here, if we take x is equal to 0, x is equal to 0, if you take y x is equal to 0, the value of y you are getting